Hello students, in the digital lecture series, I am Dr. Bhavna Mohite from Department of Microbiology, Bajaj College of Science, Wardha. Today going to talk on EMP pathway, which is been also called by glycolysis. So it has been one of the important pathway in the subject of microbiology. So before going to start with the actual lecture, I welcome you all students and ask to join this lecture. So before going to see the EMP pathway, first we will clear with the what do you mean by metabolic pathway. So metabolic pathway is a chain of enzymatic reactions. So when we call it as pathway, so pathway is a collection of step-by-step modification, step-by-step reaction, where the initial substance, it is been used as a substrate by the first enzyme and that converting or transforming that substance into the product. So substance is there, it works as a substrate, acted upon by the enzyme, converting it into the product. Now this product, it will work as a substrate for the next enzyme and converting it into the product. Suppose it is product number 2 now. Like that way, the product 2, it will be the substrate for the next coming enzyme. So it is a chain of reaction or subsequent reaction will going to take place. Up to what? So up to the product will going to get formed, which will be the exact chemical structure product which is necessary for the cell to get produced. So up to that, the reaction is going to continue. So this is what we can call as a pathway, in which there is a collection of step-by-step modification with the help of enzymatic reaction. So when we talk about metabolic pathways are of three types. One is anabolic pathway, other is a catabolic pathway, third one is the amphibolic pathway. The first one, anabolic pathway, it is about what? That it is about the synthesis reactions. When there is a synthesis of compound takes place, like protein gets synthesized by the building block of amino acids, or it may be the fuel reserve, that is in the form of fats or in the form of triglyceride, or maybe the glycogen gets synthesized. So it is been a type of anabolic pathway. So as there is a formation of some particular biological micromolecule or compound is get formed, so it's need energy, and so that's why these are the endergonic reactions. While in the second type, that is catabolism, what happen? It is a breakdown reactions. So what mean the complex compound, it is get degraded into simpler form. Okay, for example, that what we are going to learn today, EMP pathway or glycolysis, where the glucose, which is a 6-carbon compound, it is get converted into 3-carbon compound. So it's simpler form. So during this reaction, there is a energy formation. So this is will be a exergonic type of reaction, producing the energy either in the form of ATP or either in the form of reducing equivalence. This is called catabolic pathway. The third type is there, that is amphibolic pathway. So amphibolic pathways, these are actually the crossroad of metabolism. So this is going to work as a linkage between the catabolism and anabolism. So this is being the pathway which is going to link the both of the type of pathway, catabolism and anabolism. For example, citric acid cycle. Okay, which is going to link the anabolism as well as catabolism. See this particular one, this is being the outline of catabolism of carbohydrate, proteins and fats. Carbohydrate, protein and fat, these are the important biological micromolecules. Once we get the diet, we get it through the diet, and once it digested and absorbed, it get converted into its simpler form. Like digestion of carbohydrate gives you simple sugar, mainly the glucose. Protein gives you amino acids, fats get converted into fatty acid and glycerol. And finally these three get catabolized and get converted into acetyl-CoA. And as we say that, this citric acid cycle, it has been a link between catabolism and anabolism. So further this acetyl-CoA, it's enter within the citric acid cycle and finally it's give the carbon dioxide molecule to get formed, get mineralized finally to the carbon dioxide along with the energy formation. Okay, so this has been the outline that how these three of them it is undergo catabolism, giving you the simpler form of compounds. Now further, we will see the overview of carbohydrate metabolism. That why the carbohydrate metabolism is particularly having the importance and how it is get linked with the other type of biomolecule metabolism. Through the diet, we get the glucose converted into glucose 6-phosphate. Further, it get converted into pyruvate through the glycolysis pathway. While if the glucose is in excess, so it is get reserved in the form of energy-rich molecule glycogen. While through this glucose phosphate, it may enters within the pentose phosphate also, and that resulted into the triose phosphate and pentose phosphate like ribose phosphate, which will be useful for the RNA and DNA formation. Then what may be this glucose get converted into pyruvate, it may having a linkage to the protein pathway that further having the energy in citric acid cycle. While through the pyruvate converting into intermediate compound acetyl-CoA, it's having entry within the citric acid cycle, and also the other way is go towards the fat or lipid metabolism. So this has been how actually through the acetyl-CoA it's having a linking with the lipid metabolism. So you could say that the carbohydrate metabolism having the importance because the major pathways and its 8 products, it is going to have a linkage with the other biomolecule pathways also. In today's lecture, we'll particularly focus on EMP pathway. It is also known as glycolysis. Why EMP? Because three of the physiologists going to discover this pathway, and so giving a credit to them, the pathway has been named after them. So it is Gustav Embeden, Otto Meyerhoff and Jacob Carnap-Parnas. According to their names, the pathway has been named as EMP, Embeden-Meyerhoff-Parnas pathway. So more likely it is to be called as glycolysis. Glycolysis, the term, it is from the Greek word glycas means sweet, and the lysis means splitting. So splitting of sugar, splitting of sweet is there. So that terms indicates the glycolysis. Glucose, if you consider, it is a major fuel for most of the organism. It is very rich in energy. When we talk about its complete oxidation to carbon dioxide and water molecule, it is giving the high amount of energy in the, that is standard free energy change is about -2840 kilojoules per mole. So it's a very high potential energy is there. If it is the case that the glucose is there, oxidation through glycolysis, it is giving a pyruvate, giving a high amount of energy further to enter in the TCA cycle. If it is in excess, so it could be stored in the form of polysaccharide material like a glycogen or starch as an energy reserve. Then if there is a need of energy, so it can be quickly get converted into glucose. And further can glucose be converted into pyruvate, releasing the energy in the form of ATP, aerobically or anaerobically. So we could say that glucose, it is being considered as a very versatile building block for basic metabolic reaction of particularly those which is having a carbon skeleton, including the fatty acids as well as the amino acids. So now we will see the actual pathway of glycolysis. See, at one glance, this is the pathway of glycolysis or EMP. This is having two of the phases, preparatory phase and payoff phase. Preparatory phase, it's having 5 reactions, and payoff phase, it's having the next 5 reactions. So total 10 reactions are there. Starting with glucose, in the preparatory phase, it gets converted into 2 molecules of 3-carbon compound. and in the next phase, in payoff phase, these two molecules of three carbon compound is used to further get converted into two molecules of pyruvate. So it's having these two of the phases. We will see one by one. First we start with the preparatory phase. So in preparatory phase, what is happening? That it is causing phosphorylation of glucose and finally its conversion into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So how it is to be done, that we'll see. The first reaction of the pathway is, it is glucose. Glucose gets converted into glucose 6-phosphate. So it is a phosphorylation reaction at which the hydroxyl group on carbon number 6, it is get phosphorylated. So it is get phosphorylated at the 6 carbon position, for which it needs the phosphate group, which is donated by the ATP molecule. So it's converted into glucose 6-phosphate, and the enzyme which works for this, it is hexokinase. The next step of the pathways, glucose 6-phosphate get converted into fructose 6-phosphate. So here it is a phosphohexoisomerase converting the aldo form of sugar to a ketose form of sugar, that is glucose 6-phosphate get converted into fructose 6-phosphate, and the enzyme is phosphohexoisomerase. Further, this fructose 6-phosphate, it's get converted into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, and here in this case, this fructose 6-bisphosphate, it again requires the another phosphate group, which is donated by a next molecule of ATP. So converting fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, carrying one another phosphate group from ATP, and the enzyme is phosphofructokinase 1. So here in this case, it is having now rich molecule, a very complex molecule yet form fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. This fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, it's up till now having the 6 carbon sugar or 6 carbon backbone. Now the next enzyme will work, which is the enzyme that is called as a aldoses. So aldoses is going to act on fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, and that causing its cleavage into two molecules of 3 carbon compound, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Both of them, these are the triose sugars. And finally, this dihydroxyacetone phosphate get converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by the enzyme triose phosphate isomerase. So both of them, these are the aldose and ketose sugar. Both of them are triose type of sugars. So one is get converted into two. So finally, at the end of preparatory phase, we have, starting with glucose 6 carbon compound, and at the end we have the two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate at the end of preparatory phase. So if you summarize the preparatory phase, is that in preparatory phase there is two molecules of ATP are invested before its conversion into 2,3 carbon compound, and here this investing of energy, it's raising the free energy content of that intermediates, and the carbon chain of the metabolized hexoses, it's finally get converted into two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates. So this is the preparatory phase. Now again, quickly we're going to summarize the reactions at the structure level. See, this is the glucose, which is the aldose sugar. It is acted upon by the first enzyme, hexokinase. The hydroxyl group, it is get converted into, it's going to be replaced, and this phosphate group is been attached here at the 6 carbon, which is donated by adenine triphosphate ATP, converting into ADP adenine diphosphate in the presence of magnesium ion, and the enzyme is hexokinase. Remember, this is the irreversible reaction of the pathway. It could not be reversed back, causing conversion of glucose to glucose 6-phosphate. Then, glucose 6-phosphate acted upon by the enzyme phosphohexoisomerase in presence of magnesium ion, and get converted to its isomeric form fructose 6-phosphate. one, it is a fructose, glucose 6 phosphate to fructose 6 phosphate, aldose to keto form of sugar. Then fructose 6 phosphate acted upon by the enzyme phosphofructokinase 1, and another ATP molecule is going to engage here, donating the phosphate group at the first carbon position in the presence of magnesium ion. So now fructose 6 phosphate, it's becoming fructose 1,6 bisphosphate, and this is a very complex compound. This is a high energy compound which is going to now split in the next reaction, acted upon by the enzyme aldolase, and this 6 carbon converted into 2 molecules of 3 carbon each, dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. One is going to carry the phosphate group at the first carbon position, other is going to carry the phosphate group at the 6th carbon position. Then after this, this dihydroxyacetone phosphate, it is get converted into its isomeric form. It is with the help of enzyme triose phosphate isomerase, and that will give you glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So we have 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate at the end of preparatory phase. Remember that among which these reactions, only 2 reactions which are irreversible. Glucose to glucose 6 phosphate with the help of enzyme hexokinase, and fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 bisphosphate with the help of enzyme phosphofructokinase 1. Because why to remember these reactions which are irreversible? Because these are the reactions which undergo regulation, which regulate this pathway further. Then we will move on with the next phase, and that is payoff phase. In payoff phase starting, we have 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates. So the first reaction starts with oxidative conversion of this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and its phosphorylation with the help of enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, where the NAD plus, it works as acceptor for the hydrogen as a reducing power acceptor, converting into NADH plus H plus ion and forming 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate from glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate. This NADH which is going to form here, it is again utilized in the reaction, and then it will reform or get, it is going to recirculate the NAD plus as an acceptor here in the reaction of TCA cycles. So thus it will carry out or it will continue the acceptor to be there in the form of NAD plus to get the hydrogen during this reaction. Then further 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, it is going to convert it into 3-phosphoglycerate, and this is the first ATP forming reaction by substrate level phosphorylation reaction with the help of enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase. It is giving the 2 molecules of ATP to get synthesized. Then 3-phosphoglycerate converted into 2-phosphoglycerate with the help of enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase. So it is having only the position of carbon from 3 carbon to 2 carbon, the phosphate group is get changes from 3 to, it comes to 2 carbon. Then this 2-phosphoglycerate get converted to its enol form, that is phosphoenol pyrate, with the help of enzyme enolase. And in the next reaction, that is phosphoenol pyruvate conversion to a pyruvate with the second ATP forming reaction and for substrate level phosphorylation with the release of energy forming ATP molecule with the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase, forming 2 molecules of pyruvate. If you see the net reaction, we start with glucose. What we needed during this, we required the NAD plus, 2 molecules of NAD plus, 2 molecules of ADP and inorganic phosphate, and that resulted into 2 molecules of pyruvate, 2 molecules of NADH plus H plus ion, 2 molecules of ATP with the water molecule. So this is the net reaction of the pathway. We are now going to see the payoff phase reaction at the structural level. So we have started with what? We have started with this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So we have two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So in the first reaction, which is the oxidative phosphorylation reaction, where this NAD plus works as an acceptor for the hydrogen and converted into NADH plus H plus ion, formation of reducing equivalent, and inorganic phosphate is been there, which causes this conversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to have one addition of phosphate group to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. The enzyme is glyceraldehyde 3-phospho dehydrogenase. So at the first and 3 carbon position, there is a presence of phosphate group. So it is a oxidation and substrate level phosphorylation reaction, which is going to occur by this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase with the synthesis of NADH plus H plus ion, two molecules. Then how this NADH plus H plus ions, these are get, what is it is get formed? So see here, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, it is been there, get converted further into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. So thing is what, that it should be recycled, because we bond the NAD plus again for this reaction to take place. Okay, so here it is going to have one of the reaction that has been occurring in the TCA cycle with generating this NAD plus again, so that it could be available for this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate phosphate to undergo oxidation and get converted into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. So we have this 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate now, after which it is acted upon by the phosphoglycerate kinase enzyme in magnesium ion presence, and ADP going to accept that phosphate group from this 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate and becoming ATP. And as it is donating one phosphate group, it remaining with one, and that is at the 3 carbon position, 3-phosphoglycerate. This 3-phosphoglycerate, it's now just passes from 3-phosphoglycerate to carbon number 2, that is 2-phosphoglycerate, with the help of enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase and magnesium ion presence. So passing of phosphate group from 3 to 2nd carbon, forming 2-phosphoglycerate. This 2-phosphoglycerate, it is a mutase enzyme. So it is a, how the interconversion going to occur, it is been shown over here, the phosphoryl group transfer, which is occurring between the 3 carbon to 2 carbons. So we now have phosphoglycerate with us, 2-phosphoglycerate, which is acted upon by the enzyme enolase. And with this water molecule removal, see this one, this water molecule gets removed, and now we have phosphoenol pyruvate. We have this phosphoenol pyruvate. This is enolic form. So this phosphoenol pyruvate then giving you the next ATP molecule. So it is again donating this phosphate group towards ADP in the presence of magnesium and calcium ions, and the enzyme is pyruvate kinase, and causing its conversion into pyruvate and generating the second molecule of ATP. Okay, so this is how the pyruvate it is get synthesized. This pyruvate which is get synthesized, it is in the pyruvate form, it is in the enol form. So this enol form, it is undergo tautomerization reaction giving you the pyruvate that is in the keto form. So I hope so you could understand this particular pathway. Now once the pyruvate it is get formed, what happens to that? Okay, so we will see the fate of pyruvate. Once the glucose gets synthesized into two molecules of pyruvate, it is having three fates. In aerobic condition, with the removal of carbon dioxide, it is going to convert it into acetyl-CoA, which enters in a citric acid cycle or TCA cycle, and it's completely get metabolized into carbon dioxide and water molecule. This happens in aerobic condition in animal, plant as well as microbes. While in case of anaerobic condition or hypoxic condition, in case of yeast particularly, which undergo fermentation forming the ethanol and carbon dioxide. While the anaerobic condition is there, but the enzyme is lactate dehydrogenase in contracting muscles, erythrocytes or in some other cell and microbes, it is get converted into lactic acid. So either of the fates are there, either aerobic conditions giving entering within this TCA cycle and causing the conversion finally into metabolized into carbon dioxide and water molecule, or it may be the ethanol formation or it may be the lactic acid formation. So depending upon the condition, the pyruvate may be having further its either of the fate. Okay. Now after this, we're going to see the how the pathway it is get regulated. See the regulation of the pathway. There are three reactions of the pathway which are irreversible in nature. Okay, what are the three of the reactions? First one is glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, which is acted upon by the enzyme hexokinase. Then the next reaction is there, that is from fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 base phosphate with the help of enzyme phosphofructokinase 1. And the next reaction is of phosphoenol pyruvate to pyruvate with the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase. This all three reactions, these are irreversible reaction and these are undergo allosteric regulation. So this allosteric regulation, here it indicates what? That at the enzyme site, active site, there is an allosteric site which is going to get blocked, and that resulted into enzyme inhibition. And thus it will can able to control the flow of carbon through this pathway, and that can maintain the level of glucose within the cell. Okay. So here it has been shown in the first slide, glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, these three of the compound, deoxyglucose, lonidamide, 3-bromopyruvate, three of them going to work as an inhibitor of this particular reaction. Even this further one, glucose 6 phosphate, if it is going to enter within the pentose phosphate pathway, so at this level also it could be also regulated. Okay, so it may be the 6 amino nicotinic acid may going to work as an inhibitor for this enzyme, and further as an intermediate of this glycolytic pathway, that is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, which is further converted into pyruvate. So this pyruvate, it will not going to enter further into the TCA cycle, and maybe the thing that this is due to the hypoxic conditions, it may going to have the inhibition of conversion of pyruvate further into acetyl-CoA entering the TCA cycle. So at this level it may also going to have the blocking of the pathway. It has been also found that in cancerous cell formation, it is going to inhibit the glycolysis to get occurs. So that has been also going to have the inhibitory effect on that. So thus it is, we could say that glycolysis, if it is tightly regulated in coordination with other pathways, so that will going to assure that there will be a steady supply of the energy will be always there, because as we have seen that glycolysis, it is been going to have a rich potential energy. Now after this, we will going to see the balance sheet of this pathway. Balance sheet, it's for, means what? The balance sheet, it's for that how many moles of ATP it is utilized or energy is utilized, and how much is been get actually invested, utilized or invested, and how much is been formed. So for glycolysis, it has been said that for glycolysis, it is spending little and getting a lot. Is it? So why is it so? That it is for each molecule of glucose, we know that there are two ATP molecules are spent. Okay, what are the reactions? Glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, and the other one is what? Fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. So here the two molecules of ATP are utilized in the preparatory phase, while 4 ATP molecules are produced in the PR phase. Why? Because we know that there are two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, and from each of them it is giving up two molecules of pyruvate, and during the reactions at two of the states it is giving a ATP molecule formation, 2 ATP at 1 and another 2 ATP at another reactions. What are the reactions over there? So one of them, it has been 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate 2 forming the 3 bisphosphoglycerate, and the next one is phosphoenol pyruvate 2 pyruvate. So here 4 ATP molecules are produced in pair of feeds. So thing is what, if you calculate the net yield now, so we have 2 molecules are invested, 4 ATP molecules are produced. So that's why the 2 molecules of ATP are being the net yield of this glycolysis pathway or AMP pathway. So also we should also take into consideration of what NADH that has been formed per molecule of glucose. Okay, but as this NADH, it is having the linking of NAD plus availability, and that is linked with the TCA cycle. So that's why we are not going to calculating or taking consideration of this NADH at this level up to the end of glycolysis. So up to the end of glycolysis from glucose to pyruvate only, we could say that the net yield is 2 molecules of ATP per molecule of glucose used. Okay, and so that's why this is in the net reaction, glucose plus 2 NAD plus 2 ADP in organic phosphate, with that giving you 2 pyruvate, 2 NADH plus glucosan and 2 ATP. With the net yield of energy, we could say that it is going to have the 2 molecules of ATP that has been formed with per molecule of glucose used. So students, thank you for your patient listening, and I hope that you have might understand the AMP pathway, its reaction, which enzymes works in that, and how it is get regulated, and what is the net yield of energy. So further, if you can have any of the queries or any information you need, so you can please visit to this website. So thank you.